yes, the virgin, but more important, we dealt with the dragon and his powerful forces.
Virgin, Drudumiginyaye, Nagane, Duye.
Who was the dragon?
Nagabadule. Shimwi Haunu called it Nagaya.
Who is the dragon? Satan. I want you to be expressive, huh? Maybe this is not your style. We are doing studies together. The dragon is Satan and also the Roman Empire, right? The first beast, who is it? Who is the first beast? That controls the world in 1260
years.
Church of Rome, or Church of Rome, or the Catholic Church.
Yeah?
Then the second beast. America. America. Good.
American.
So this is on Satan's side. Very powerful forces. Are you agreeable? It's like the Median
Knights.
This tree, the dragon, the papacy, and the America Protestant Church controls the world.
Protestant America.
Today, first lesson, we want to study this 144,000 that follows the Lamb wherever he goes. On God's side is always the minority. Because the world belongs to Satan. God do not force religion upon us. But Satan do. That's why he can control the whole world. This was what we studied yesterday. Huh? In verse 17, it closes chapter 12 with this statement. And you have your. You have your Bible?
Revelation chapter 12, verse 17.
It ends in this chapter that says the dragon was angry with the woman. God has protected the woman in the wilderness for
1260
years. After that period, so he go and make war with the remnant of her seed. The remnant church. This remnant church has two characteristics. They obey the commandments of God. And they have the testimony of Jesus. So, do you keep the commandment? Yesterday I asked.
Yes,
raise your hand if you do. The Ten Commandments by God's grace. Amen. Do you have the testimony of Jesus? Okay. The testimony of Jesus can be two interpretations.
Yeshua ta de khan jet go chano lo adibe na myo phwin lo ya de.
One is the spirit of prophecy which we as a church we have.
Two are da winyin do yi ta tha de winyin prophet ho de winyin tabor de.
But more importantly the question is to each one of us, do we have the testimony of Jesus?
Da mae po bi ye ji da ga chano lo di Yeshua ta de khan jet de chano lo
ma. If someone asks me why you believe in Jesus?
လူတယောက်ကကျွန်တော်တို့ကိုမေးဘာကြောင့်သင်ယေရှုကိုယုံကြည်နေတယ်လဲလို့မေးမယ်ဆိုခင်ဗျားတို့ဘယ်လိုဖြေမလဲ
Whether is a Hindu a Buddhist or Muslim
Hindu Buddha ဘာသာဝင် Muslim ဘာသာဝင်ကျွန်တော်တို့ကိုကျွန်တော်တို့ယုံကြည်ခြင်းနဲ့ပတ်သက်လို့မေးမြန်းလာမယ်ဆိုရင
် Or now more and more secular people who don't believe there is a God who depends on money as their God
နော်ခင်လွန်တဲ့ခင်မီတဲ့ခင်မာတော့တချို့ကြောင်လဲငွေကြီးဥစ္စာတနာတွေကိုပဲအရေးထားတယ်ဘာသာတရားနဲ့ပတ်သက်လို့သိအရေးမထားတဲ့လူတွေလည်းအများကြီးပဲ
Do you have a testimony to share?
ယေရှုရဲ့သက်တည်ခံခြင်းနဲ့ကျွန်တော်တို့ဘာဝင်ငှစရာရှိ
It's very important.
ယေရှုအရေးကြီးပါတယ
် Is your life connected with Jesus? Do you know that he is a real God, a powerful God?
ယနေ့ကျွန်တော်တို့
God who change your life and a God who takes care of you.
ကျွန်တော်တို့အသက်တာကယေရှုခရစ်တော်နဲ့ဘလောက်ဆက်သွယ်မှုကောင်းနေတယ်လဲ
ကျွန်တော်တို့ကိုတွေ့ကားနဲ့
ဆောင်မတယ်ကောင်းကြည့်ပေးတယ
်လမ်းပြဖို့ဆောင် with your friends
ကျွန်တော်တို့ရဲ့ငယ်ချင်းတွေကျွန်တော်တို့ရဲ့ဆွေမျိုးတွေနဲ့ဘလို့ကျွန်တော်တို့ဝေငှသက်သေခံတယ်လဲ
that will convince them that you believe in a true god a god that is alive
အသက်ရှင်တဲ့ဘုရားနဲ့ကျွန်တော်တို့ကဘလို့ဆက်သွယ်လဲဆိုတာယနေ့သက်သေပြဖို့ပါရှိတယ်
This remnant we are going to study today.
တော်ဒီယနေ့ကြံကျွင်းတဲ့အသင်းတော်အကြောင်းကိုကျွန်တော်တို့လေ့လာဖို့ဖြစ်ပါ
In Revelation chapter 7 verse 2 and 3. Verse 2 and 3.
ဓာရိခန်းကြီးခုနှစ်ငယ်1နဲ့3မှာကြည့်မယ်နော်အသက်ရှင်သောဘုရားသခင်ဒစိတ်ပါသောကောင်းကင်တမန်တစ်ပါးသည်အရှိမျက်နာကတက်လာသည်ကိုငါမြင်၏သူသည်လည်းမြေနှစ်ပင်လယ်ကိုညှင်းဆဲရသောအခွင့်ကိုကောင်းကင်တမန်4ပါးအခွင့်ရှိသောကောင်းကင်တမန်၄ပါးကိုအသံလွှင့်၍ငါတို့ဘုရားသခင်ကျွန်တို့ကိုနှဖူး၌တစိမ့်မခတ်မီတိုင်အောင်မြေပင်လယ်သစ်ပင်တို့ကိုမငင်းဆဲပါနှင့်ဟူကြီးသောအသံနှင့်ကြွေးကြော်လေ
၏ It says John saw
ယောဟန်အတရာယူပါယူမှာတွေ့တယ
် An angel from the east coming up from the east
အရှိဘက်ကလာတဲ့ကောင်းကင်တမန
် What does east stand for?
အရှိအရက်ကဘာကိုပုံဆောင်တယ်လဲအရှိအရက်မှာဘာရှိလဲနေထွက်ရာအရက
် Anybody East where the sun rises
နေထွက်တဲ့အရက်အရှိအရက်ဘာကိုပုံဆောင်တယ်လဲ
That's where heaven is at the east
အော်ကောင်းကင်ရဲ့အလင်း
When Jesus comes Jesus in Matthew chapter 24 he says when I come as lightning from the east to the west
မာသဲ24မှာခရစ်တော်ယေရှုပြောတယ် "तू လူသားကြွလာတဲ့အခါမှာလျက်စီလက်သလိုအရှိအရက်ကနေထွက်ပြီးအနောက်ထိ"
This angel came from heaven
ဒီကောင်းကင်တမန်ကကောင်းကင်ကနေဆင်းသက်လာတယ
် of the living god
ဘုရားရဲ့တစိမ့်အသက်ရှင်တဲ့ဘုရားရဲ့တစိမ့်နဲ
့ And he cried out he shouted
နော်ကြီးသောအသံနဲ့ကြွေးကြော်
to the four angels that controls this world this earth
ကဘာကြီးကိုထိမ့်ချုပ်တဲ့ကောင်းကင်တမန်၄ပါးကိုသူကကြီးသောအသံနဲ့
this four angels are powerful angels
ဒီကောင်းကင်တမန်၄ပါးကလည်းတကယ်တကူကြီးတဲ့ကောင်းကင်တမန်၄ပါးဖြစ်
when they release the power they release the control
သူတို့ရဲ့ထိမ့်ချုပ်မှုကိုသူတို့ဖြေလျော့လိုက်တာနဲ့ဘာတွေဖြစ
် The world will be in turmoil
ဒီနေ့ကဘာကြီးကတော့နော်ငရ
ဲ For in verse 3 it says hurt the angel from heaven says don't hurt this earth yet
အဲ့ဒီအရှိကလာတဲ့ကောင်းကင်တမန်ကြီးဒီကဘာကြီးကိုမထိခိုက်ဖို့နော
် Don't hurt the sea don't hurt the trees
နော်ပင်လယ်နဲ့သစ်ပင်နဲ့လေကိုနော်မ
ဟုတ်ပါနဲ့ destroy don't destroy them
မဖျက်ဆီးပါသေးနဲ့လို့
Till we have sealed the servants of our God
ဖျားရဲ့သားသမီးတွေရဲ့နှစ်ဖူးမှာတစိမ့်ခတ်ခြင်းမပြီးမိတိုင်အောင်
ဝဲကြီးကပြောတယ် Where is the seal?
ဘယ်ဟာဘယ်မှာတစိမ့်ခတ်တယ်လဲဘယ်မှာတစိမ့်ခတ်မလဲ
What does that mean? Seal in the forehead? Yesterday we studied the mark of the beast is in two places. Can be in two places. But the seal only one place. In the head. When you put your seal onto a document, that means this is it. I am fully agreeable with this document. So when God put the seal on us, He says, "You are my people forever."
But are you sure you can be God's people forever? We waver like Gideon.
One day we say we are on fire for God. We can fight this war. Another day we are afraid.
Now the name
of our eyes. So when God sealed, that means He has confidence in each one of us already. No matter what situation is, we will not waver. A seal contains the name, the title, and the territory. And where can we find the seal of God? In the Ten Commandments. In the Fourth Commandment. Concerning the Sabbath, God says, "This is my Sabbath." He says, "Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy." At the end, He says, "He is the Creator." You remember the Sabbath day because He is the Creator. Let's turn to the Fourth Commandment and read it all out together. Exodus chapter 20. Let's all turn there and let's read together.
Read in Burmese?
Yes. Let's read together. Therefore, from here, we find that the name of God is the Lord. And His title is Creator of heaven, earth, and sea. His territory is heaven and earth. So that's the seal of the living God. The angels that have this seal want to seal in God's people. In verse 4, Revelation
7.
Shall I read? Yes, please.
ပြာရိခုနှစ်အငယ်လေးမှာဆိုရင်တစိခတ်ချင်းကိုခံရတော်သူအရေးအတွက်ကိုငါကြား၍ဤဒီလအမျိုးသားတို့၌အသီးအသီးသောအမျိုးအနွယ်ထဲကလူအသိန်း4,000တို့သည်တစိခတ်ချင်းကိုခံရကြ၏
Here John was given the message
ယောဟန်ကဒီသတင်းကိုကြားတယ်နော်အတန်ထဲမှာကြားတယ်
He says I heard the number of them that were sealed
တစိခတ်ချင်းကိုခံရတော်သူအရေးအတွက်ကိုငါကြား၍
There were 144,000
လူတသိန်း4,000လို့ပါတစိခတ်ချင်းကိုခံရတယ်
From all tribes of children of Israel
ဣသေလအမျိုးအနွယ်တွေထဲက
And he goes on to name every tribe 12,000
အဲ့ဒီမှာသူ12နွယ်ကိုသူနာမည်နဲ့ဖော်ပြတာတွေ့
So is this an absolute number or a subjective number?
တခါတည်းရင်ဒါကဒီလိုင်းအတိအကျပဲလားဒါပုံဆောင်တဲ့အရေးအတွက်လား
doesn't matter if it's absolute number the number is very small
မတော်ဒီ3,400အတိပဲဖြစ်ရမယ်ဆိုရင်အတိအကျဖြစ်မယ်ဆိုရင်တော
့ if it's a subjective number
ဒါပေမဲ့အခြားတစ်ဖက်မှာတော့ဒါပုံဆောင်ခြင်
း and you look at the characteristic of this 144,000 it is not
the 3,400ရဲ့เนาะအကြီးအသေးတွေသူတို့ရဲ့ဝိသေသတွေကတော်တော်လေးကိုမလွယ်ကူပါဘူ
း 12,000 from each tribe what does that mean
တမျိုးမှာ 12,000 ဒါဘာကိုညီညွတ်တာလဲ
That means every single people that God has created on this earth has that opportunity to be saved
ဘုရားရှင်ဖန်ဆင်းတဲ့လူသားတွေအလုံးမှာတူညီတဲ့နော်ခံစားခွင့်မတော့အခွင့်အရေးရှိတယ်ကယ်တင်ခြင်းရဖို့အတူညီတဲ့အခွင့်အရေးရှိတာကိုပုံဆောင်ပါတယ
် Nobody is left out
ဘသူ့မှာဘုရားရှင်ကချွင်းချံမထားပါဘူ
း Every single type of person whichever month you are born whichever year you are born you have that opportunity which nation you are born
ဘယ်မှာဘာလူပဲဖြစ်ဖြစ်အားလုံးအတွက်တူညီတဲ့အခွင့်အရေးရှိတာ
But the question is do you want to be among the 144,000.
ဒါပေမဲ့မိကုံးကတော့ဒီ3,400မှာပါဝင်ဖို့ကျွန်တော်တို့ကျမတို့ဆန္ဒရှိသလား
So if the seal of God is the Sabbath.
ဘုရားရဲ့တစိတ်တော်ကဥပုံနေ့ဖြစ်တယ်ဆိုရင်
the mark of the beast should also be a day concerning a day of worship.
နော်။ဒါရဲ့တစိတ်ကလည်းဒီဝတ်ပြုကိုးကွယ်ခြင်းနဲ့နေ့နဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့အရာလဲ
Can someone tell me Muslim worship on what day?
ဘလို့နေ့မှာကျွန်တော်တို့ဝတ်ပြုကိုးကွယ်တယ်လေယနေ
့ Friday they go to the mosque Friday noon
မွတ်စလင်တွေကတော့တောက်ကြနေ့နေ့လယ်မှာပလီသွားပြီးတော့သူ့ဝတ်ပြုဆုတောင်းတယ
် What about the Hindus
Hindu တွေရော
Full moon
လာပြေလာကွယ်တယ်လား
Actually Hindus don't have a specificdays they have festivals
hindu ကတော့သူတို့မှာတော့သတ်မှတ်ထားတဲ့ယတိတိကျရာမရှိတိုင်းပဲသူတို့မှာဘာသာရေးပွဲနေ့တွေအတွက်တော့သူတို့
maybe full moon is also a festival
မတော်တချို့ကတော့လာပြည့်နေ့တွေလာခွေနေ့တွေ
unlike
သူတို့ပွဲကျင်းပတဲ့ပွဲခံ
unlike muslim and christians and jews
muslim and christian နဲ့ jew တို့နဲ့မတူတဲ့တလေလေးပေါ့နော
် a specific day that they come every week to worship
သူတို့ကတော့အပတ်စဉ်တော့မရှိဘူးဒါပေမဲ့ခုနပေါ့သူကလ
Then what day does the Catholic keep?
ဒီနေ့ Catholic အသင်းတော်ကတော့ဘယ်လိုနေ့တွေမှာဝတ်ပြုလဲ
Sunday What about Protestant churches?
အခြားသော Protestant အသင်းတော်ဂိုင်းကနာတွေကဘယ်လိုနေ့မှာဝတ်ပြုလဲ
What about Buddhists?
ပထမနေ့ရပါတော့ဒီနေ့ကနေနေ့ဗုဒ္ဓဘာသာ
Protestant churches most of them also keep on Sunday What about Buddhists?
ဗုဒ္ဓဘာသာဝင်များ
Also festivals right
festivals လာပြည့်လာကွယ်ပေါ့နော်ဒါသူတို့ပွဲနေ့တွေ
So religion from India they keep festivals
ဒီနေ့အိန္ဒိယနေထွက်ပေါ်တဲ့တချို့ဘာသာကြီးတွေကတော့
The Middle Eastern countries the three major religion four keeps one week one day holy
ဒီအရှိလေပိုင်းကနေထွက်ပေါ်လာတဲ့ကုနာဘာသာရဲ့တွေကြတော့တပတ်ကိုတရက်ကိုသူတန့်ရှင်းနေ
ဖြစ်ဝတ်ပြုတယ် What day do they keep
ဒီနေ့ကဘာတကဘာလုံးအောင်ဘယ်နေ့ကိုစောင့်ထိန်ကြတယ်လဲ
Sunday
ကဘာအများကြိုက်တာတော့ Sunday ပေါ့နော်။ဘာကြောင့်လဲ
How did that happen?
ဘယ်လိုလုပ်ပြီးတော့ဖြစ်လာလဲ။တနင်္ဂနွေနေ့ကိုစောင့်ထိန်တဲ့
Because of the dragon or the beast, which one?
နဂါးကြောင့်လားမဟုတ်လဲ။သားရဲကြောင့်လားဟမ
် Because the Sunday holiday was created by the Roman Empire.
တနင်္ဂနွေနေ့နော်အားလက်ရက်ကိုတော့ဒီရောမ Empire ခင်မာတော့
တာ To worship the sun.
ဒါနေကိုကိုးကွယ်တဲ့နော်သူတို့နေ့တနေ့
It's a lost religion, but that religion is adopted by the Catholic Church.
မှန်ပါတယ်အဲ့ဒီဒီလေးကိုဒီနေ့ Catholic အသင်းတော်ကဆက်လက်ပြီးတော့လက်ခံကျင့်သုံးပြီးတော့တွင်သင်နေခြင်းဖြစ်ပါတယ
် So the whole world keeps Sunday.
ဒါကြောင့်ဒီနေ့တကဘာလုံးအများစုက
as a off day
နင်းတွင်နေ့ကိုအားလက်ရက်တစ်ခုအနေနဲ့
စောင့်ထိန်တယ် Whether it's a mark on the hand or on the forehead
လက်မှာပဲတစိ့ကိုခံသည်ဖြစ်စီနှဖူးမှာပဲတစိ့ကိုခံသည်ဖြစ
် Sunday including seven day adventists don't work
နော်ဒီနေ့တွင်နေ့ဆိုရင်စနေနေ့နေ့လည်းအလုပ်မလုပ်ဘူးတဲ့ဟုတ်ရဲ့လားဗော
Yes
မှန်လား
That's how powerful the dragon isIn able to change the whole world. Even in Muslim countries, used to be Friday, Saturday is Friday is half day, Saturday is off.
Muslim time bi ma raw ma na Friday ma ni twae sine ni ma pait bi mae.
Even that in the last 20 years it has changed.
Da dia lo ngai ne 20 ma piao le la bi yo ni ni ya da
tin ni ni. Saturday half day and full day off.
နော်စနေမှာလဲနေ့တဝက်နဲ့တနင်္ဂနွေနေ့ကိုတနေ့လုံးနော်မွတ်စလင်တွေကလဲ off ပေးတယ
် so this is to prepare for the mark of the beast
ဒါကသားရဲတစိ့ကိုယနေ့ပြင်ဆင်နေတဲ့လမ်းကြောင်းပဲဖြစ်ပါတယ
် revelation 13 verse 16
ဗျာဒိတ်ကျမ်း73ငယ်16 13 16 shall I read
chapter 13 verse 16 and 17
16 ဆက်ခွန်မှာဆိုရင်ငွေရတတ်သောသူဆင်းရဲသောသူကြွခံရသောလူလွတ်တော်သူအကြီးငယ်ရှိသမျှတို့သည်လက်ရလက်၌ဖြစ်စေနဖူး၌ဖြစ်စေတစိ့လက်မှတ်ကိုခံစေခြင်းက၎င်းထိုတစိ့လက်မှတ်တည်ဟူသောတာရဲဤနာမဖြစ်စေနာမအရေးအတွက်ဖြစ်စေတစ်ခုခုကိုမခံသောသူတယောက်မျှမယောင်းမဝယ်စေခြင်းက၎င်းစီရင်
ဤ He means America in Revelation
ဒုတိယတာရဲ
Second Beast
ဒုတိယတာရဲ American ရဲ
့ He say cause
လှုပ်ဆောင်မှု
cause how many people all
ဘသူတွေလဲဆိုတော့ရှိသမျှတော့အားလုံးကိုအတင
်း Both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond
လူလွတ်တွေကျွန်းနေအကုန်ကြီးတာငဲတာအကုန
် to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead
ဒီစိတ်ကိုလက်နိုင်တော့၎င်းနှဖူးနိုင်တော့၎င်းခံမှု
If you refuse
ညင်းပယ်မယ်လက်မခံဘူးဆိုရင
် It goes on to say that no man might buy or sell save he that has the mark
ဘယ်လိုပြောလဲဆိုတော့မခံသောသူတယောက်မျှမယောင်းမဝယ်စီခြင်းကစီးရင်တယ
် or the name of the beast
ဒါရဲ့တစိ့ကိုလက်မခံဘူးဆိုရင
် or the number of his name
သူရဲ့နံပါတ်ရဲ့အရေးအတွက
် the monk is the Sunday observance
Sunday မှာသာတော့တနင်္ဂနွေနေ့ကိုစောင့်ထိန်ခြင်
း receiving on the hand means you don't agree but you follow
လက်မှာရရှိခြင်းအရ
ခင
်ဗျားတော့လက်တော့မခံဘူးဒါပေမဲ့လိုက်လျှောက်တယ
် because you are afraid to be persecuted afraid
လက်မှာခံခြင်းအဖြစ်ကိုတ
ော့ able to buy or sell
မခံရဘူးเนาะရောင်းဝယ်ခြင်းမိတ်လည်းမပြတ်အောင်ဒါလိုက်လျောတဲ့သဘောဖြစ်ပါတယ
် when you have the mark on the head it means you believe this is truly God's holy day
နှစ်ဖူးမှာစိတ်ခံခြင်းအရတော့နော်ตาเยတစိ့နှစ်ဖူးမှာခံချင်အောင်တနင်္ဂနွေနေ့ရတာตาเยမှန်တဲ့အရာတစ်ခု
so
when လျှောက်မယ့်အရာတစ်ခုလို့ယုံကြည်ခြင်းဖြစ်
National Sunday law is passed you have to decide
ဒါကြောင့် National Sunday law ပေါ့နော်အမေရိကန်နိုင်ငံကနေထုတ်ပြန်တဲ့တနင်္ဂနွေနေ့ကိုတန်ရှင်းတဲ့နေ့လုံးမလုံးရနေ့လို့ထုတ်ပြန်တဲ့တနေ့မှာဆိုရင်ဒ
ါ If you go against US you cannot buy cannot sell
ဒါကိုလက်မခံဘူးဆိုရင်ကျွန်တော်တို့ကစီးပွားရေးအရာ
ပိတ်ဆို့တာ against you
ခံရလိမ့်မယ်စီးပွားရေးပိတ်ဆို့တာလေနော
် If you don't have the name of the beast that means you are not catholic
အဲ့ဒီနာမမရှိဘူးဆိုရင်ခင်ဗျားကဒီ catholic ပေါ့နော် universal အသင်းတော်မှာမပါဘူးဆိုရင်
or the number 666, which is the Pope. You don't believe the Pope is Jesus on earth, or the representative of heaven. Economic sanction will be on you. How many of you think you can survive without money? Not many, including pastor. If you say in Rangoon, do you think you can survive without money? Yes or no? No, impossible. Am I correct? The light, the aircon, the food, all you need money.
Transport.
When that time come, you are in the city, it's very tough to make the decision. Even today, all of a sudden, he says, no money for you, pastors. No salary. What do you think? Will you say, I leave the church? Or I still work for free because I'm working for God? Not easy. This economic sanction in today's world is one of the hardest tests. That's why Satan is using this to test. Yesterday I alluded to you, how can America control not buying, not selling?
It's through
this chip, possibly. It's called RFID chip.
RFID,
if you have
chip
credit card, any of you have credit card? Can you take out your credit card and see whether you have the same thing like I did? I do.
RFID chip.
In the past, it's a strip of magnetic tape.
Magnetic tape.
But today, more and more so, they put a chip there. It's on the passport.
Passport, ma shi de.
It's in my credit card. I stay in Thailand, it's on my transport card. I just need to beep and I can go already.
And
America has already invented the chip so that it can be very convenient. You just need to put it in your hand. It's like a rice grain, very small.
America ma yini thau lou de di san si li lao bae shi de chips li o thu lo let thae ma ba phe le.
Those people who are on handouts, you know, there are people who are not working but they get money from government.
Yini America ma chu a so ya thau pan chi ne atat shin ni ne lu de.
They encourage them to have this chip. So every week they go and collect their check, easy. Otherwise they will have to wait long time. With this chip, beep, they know you is you. Just like I come to Myanmar, the immigration. This is my first trip to Myanmar. They put my Simple. On passport. This means there's a RFID chip in the passport.
The passport ma RFID chips liya par.
So they just need to put it into the machine.
Now do ya immigration ya through ya scanner ma phat lai da ne tick so da.
Beep. All your information is there. In the past, they have to key in everything, your passport number, your name, everything, date of birth. Today, they just insert in. All your information is there. Where is the chip? Can you see anything? It's so small, you can only feel a little bit of it. RFID chip.
RFID chip.
Who implemented this? America. Just as small as the rice. Put in here. It's easy for you to travel, to buy things. To take train. So, I guess how America will enforce, because it's America who enforce cannot buy, cannot sell. This is the technology is available already. Putting it in your head, in your under your skin is easy. It's the injection only. Revelation 7. Sorry. First, we saw John saw the 144,000. Then, verse 9, he goes on and says, after this, I beheld great multitude. Which no man can number. He comes from all nations, all kindred, people, and tongues. They stood before the throne in heaven, before God in heaven, before the Lamb, Jesus. They clothed in white robe. On their hand is a palm of victory. Palm symbolizes victory. So John saw this scene in heaven. A victory scene. The first worship. Maybe it's the first Sabbath in heaven. And one of the 24 elders asked, verse 14
and 15. 14, 15.
Yes. The 144,000 are the people who comes out of the great tribulation. And they have washed their robe in white. In the blood of the Lamb. What does this mean?
When is the
great tribulation?
It's when
Satan has full control, when the four wings of the angels release the four wings.
But this
group of people, 144,000, they stood firm.
They are
not wavering.
They
fight the good fight.
They
tell the universe that the law can be kept.
That
God's law is fair and just and
because
the law represents, reflects the character of God.
Satan
says cannot be kept.
God, you
are
too strict.
But God says, see, I have people that you persecute fully. You have full control.
Yet
they worship me.
So
in heaven,
it
says, therefore, they, before the throne of God, they serve him day and night in his temple.
It's
such a privilege.
It's
the same as today. If the Prime Minister say you become one of my minister,
is it an honor? Is
it a privilege?
You
become the right hand, left hand, you become in the court of heaven, representing God to the universe. It's a privilege.
But let's aim
towards
that.
What are the characteristics of the
144,000?
Number one, they are totally dependent on God.
Because
we have read in Revelation 13, 16 to 17, that
When
the time comes, you cannot buy, cannot sell. What do you do?
You
have no choice but to 100% depend on God to sustain you through the
great times of trouble. Money is
useless
for
God's people.
Today we
are dependent on money, but that time comes, you are 100% dependent on God and God alone.
So number two,
characteristics that they have.
They
have the Father's name
on their forehead.
It says in Revelation 14, verse
1. Shall I read?
Yes.
Tunamanga Chilin, Totanga the Zion Damoma, Yane, Tui Namani, Kamero in Namago, Napunai, Akea Din Lodu, the thing lay down, lay down, lay, too near to Shijai.
John saw that the Lamb was standing on Mount Zion.
Yohan Badrilas Rock. Where is Mount
Zion?
Mount
Zion is the same as Jerusalem.
But here
God, John saw in heaven, that means the new Jerusalem in heaven.
Yohan Mia de Yaro, Tizioda, Yerushalim Mute, Gongin, Piashi, Dida, Yerushalim Mute, Pippa.
Jesus stand at Mount Zion, and with him 144,000.
Yeshu Kritoga.
And he says, the Father's name is written in the forehead. He's sealed with the Father's name. To have the name of the Father means you have the character of the Father. Just like your son looks like you. Your son has your surname. Your son even behaves like
you.
People say you are like your son is like you. So having the father's name is having the father's character. Number three, they sang a new song of victory.
Verse 14:3.
What is this song that they are singing in heaven? It's a song of victory. Just like when Israel crossed the Jordan, the Red Sea. After they crossed, they sang a new song of victory. So this 144,000, when they are delivered, when Jesus comes and caught them alive into to new heaven, to heaven, they sing a victory
song.
This song nobody else can sing because they have gone through the most troubled time. Why is it most troubled? Because Satan at that point of time has 100% control of the world. The Holy Spirit is withdrawn. When the Holy Spirit does not work on you, you can do terrible things. When Satan has full control of the earth, great destruction, this is why he has said.
So,
their experiences, nobody else has experienced this. Only they can sing this type of song.
Number
four characteristic. It says they are virgin, follow Jesus. They are the first fruit in verse 4.
Verse 14:4.
Woman stands for what?
The
churches.
Here it says
they are not defiled with churches. Wrong doctrines preached by the church. Their heart is purely connected to Jesus. They are virgins. They are not contaminated with other religion. It goes on to say they follow the Lamb. That means their heart is focused. They follow the Lamb wherever the Lamb goes. And God says they are redeemed from the earth as first fruit. Jesus is the first fruit. When Jesus comes again, they are the first fruit to be received.
It's
a huge, great privilege to be among the 144,000. One more thing. Number fifth. No lies.
The Pisama Gongara Muda
in their mouth were found no gall.
No man, Muda, and again, all the Yapibare.
I ask you this question. Yesterday, did you lie?
Manidua, Genoru,
you lie. Very honest. Yesterday, did you lie?
Manidua, Muda, Biomida, Shila.
Only a few of you. The rest of you, honest or not?
Generally, we are you don't have it now.
Many times when you are sneezing, you have a flu, and people come and say, "How are you?"
The cardinal general, Nazi video, Nima Gauna Chima Limia, Nigauna Lumide.
What do you say?
Chile, Blue Chile.
Huh? Fine, I'm fine.
Nigauma Lube.
When you are sick, you still say you are fine. Is that a lie or not a lie?
It's
so easy to lie. A white lie is still a lie.
The white lie
because this world is controlled by Satan. And Satan is the father of lies. Can you not lie one day? Not lie to yourself, not lie to your family, not lie to your friends. Just one day. I see one head shaking. They say businessmen always lie. Without lying, cannot be businessmen. True or not? What about pastors? Is a pastor honest people 100%? God knows and say this group of people, no God is found in them. Only by God's power we can change inside out. Only when we are aware, we admit that we are the children of the father of life. By God's power and by His forgiveness, we can become one. It's perhaps one of the hardest things to do.
But
yet, we have to do that day by day. Because God is a God of truth.
And
Satan is a God of lies.
Opposite.
The journey to God is a deliberate act with God's help. The sixth ingredient, characteristic of this group, verse 5. Just now we say lie, eh?
Lies, yes.
The second part of, and besides lie,
yes.
They say, the verse 5 says, they are without fault before the throne of God.
without fault.
Rio in Brazil is now having Olympics on. Every country sends their best to compete in Olympics. So, any one of you can represent Myanmar to the Olympic Games
or not?
None of you, because you are seated here while the game is on. Every single one of them has done their best to practice the best they can be.
In
a specific skill. So when they get to Olympics, they are competing with the world's best. So in the spiritual world, it's the same. We are coming to the Olympic game. The competition between Satan and Jesus team.
On God's side,
144,000. Who has a seal of God. Characteristic of God. They have perfected their life. They are
10-10-10.
Perfect vision. God has this group of people to compete with the best on Satan's side. The stake is very high. Either only one team will win. So, are you ready to be on Jesus' team? Let's work towards it. We cannot be on Jesus' team by our own effort. Jesus is looking for people who has perfected their character. From each nation, from each tribe, from each language. To represent him in the last generation. Practically, they are standing up like a saw thumb. Because the whole world is going against this you. That fight, we have to win. And Jesus is confident of winning this war. And he has outlined to us what he expects.
Wonder
where is 7. Anyway.
Eight.
Seven somewhere
gone.
Seven,
Eight
in verse
12.
The key is patience. Patience of the saints. Why is this so important? To have patience. It's because we need to endure hardship.
No?
We If we get angry easily, we do things wrong. Example of Jesus, when he went to the cross, he patiently endured
all the suffering.
You need great faith in the God that you worship to have patience. Because God has promised, I will see you through this suffering, this trials,
this impossibility.
That's why he says, they keep the commandments of God and they also have the faith of Jesus. The same faith that Jesus has in his Father. In order to have patience, you must have faith in the one that you're waiting. The 9th, they keep the commandments of God and have faith and testimony of Jesus. Revelation 12, 17, it says, and the dragon was angry with the woman and went to make wars with the remnant of her seed, which keeps the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. And in Revelation 19, verse 10, explains what is the testimony of Jesus Christ. For the testimony of Jesus Christ is the spirit of prophecy. God's remnant church keeps the commandments of God. And God gave this church the spirit of prophecy through Mrs. White, Ellen G. White.
Ellen White,
to guide us through this difficult time. Why is it difficult?
Because
what the Bible says and what the world practice is totally opposite. We really need the spirit of prophecy to explain things, to explain how this church can function, how this church can be victorious. A lot is at stake. This is the final church. If Jesus lose this church, he will lose this earth. Agree? So he has given this church special light. When I was young, a teenager, that is about 30, 40 years ago already, I started to hear that the church don't believe in the spirit of prophecy in America. Not the church, some people. They start to criticize the spirit of prophecy as a false, Mrs. White is a false prophet. As a young man, I'm a third generation Seventh-day Adventist. So I was wondering whether it's true what they say. So I decided to read the Bible and the spirit of prophecy for myself.
So I decided to read the Bible and the spirit of prophecy for myself. ဖတ်ရှုလေ့လာတယ
် I'm a very slow reader
ကျွန်တော်ကတော့စာဖတ်တာနှီးတယ်ပေါ့မှန်မှန်လေးပဲဖတ်တယ
် When I first read the Bible it took me 5 years to read finish
သမာကျမ်းစာအုပ်ကိုအစအဆုံးဖတ်ဖို့9နှစ်ကြာခဲ့တယ
် That was the NIV version
ဒါက NIV New International Version နဲ့သူဖတ်ခဲ့တယ် English
Because it's a easier version to understand than King James
King James တဲ့နားလည်ရလွယ်တယ်နော်ဒီ English ဘာသာပြန်တစ်ခုသူဖတ်တ
ယ် Second time round I use King James to read through
ဒုတိယတစ်ချိန်မှာတော့သူ King James Version နဲ့အစဆုံးဖတ်တယ
် I think it took me 3 years
သုံးနှစ်ကြာပြီအဲ့ဒါလေ
And then now I think I finish 8 times already in my life using different versions
ကျွန်တော်အသက်တာမှာ8ချိန်တော့ရှိသွားပြီပေါ့နော
် How many of you have finished reading the Bible once
သမာကျမ်းစာကိုတစ်ချိန်ပြီးအောင်ဖတ်ခဲ့တဲ့လူရှိလား
Amen
အစဆုံ
း Twice
နှစ်ချိန်သမာရော
Good 3 times
သုံးချိန်ပြီးအောင်ပြီးနိုင်တယ်လေ
Very good President 4 times
လေးချိန
် Ah that's why he's president
ဒါကြောင့်ဥက္ကဋ္ဌဖြစ်တာ
It's important because this is
အင်မတန်မှအရေးကြီးပါတယ်ဒါဖျားရှင်ရဲ့နှုတ်ကပတ်တော်ဖြစ်တယ
် And Mrs. White's writing I also went through
ဝိညာဉ်တော်စာပေတွေလည်းကျွန်တော်ဖတ်ရှုတယ
် How many of you finished reading testimonies to the churches
အတင်းတော်အတွက်ဩဝါဒဆိုင်ရာတွေကိုဘယ်နှကြိမ်ပြီးအောင်ဖတ်ဘူးလဲ
Amen That is one of the we are asked to read the 5 conflict series
Now the conflict of ages series စာအုပ်9ခုကိုလည်းဖတ်ဖို့အကြံပေးတ
ာ After I finished that I started reading testimonies to the churches
အဲ့ဒါပြီးတာနဲ့ကျွန်တော်အတင်းတော်အတွက်ဩဝါဒတွေကိုကျွန်တော်ဖတ်ပြန်တယ
် 9 volume so big
volume 9ခုရှိတယ် Volume 1 to 9.
Slow reader took me many years to finish.
ကျွန်တော်မှန်မှန်လေးပဲဖတ်တယ်ဆိုတော့အချိန်တော်တော်ကြာကြာကြာခဲ့တယ်အချိန်ကြီ
း. And this is what I discovered.
ဒါကျွန်တော်တွေ့ရှိတဲ့တွေ့ရှိချက်တွေဖြစ်တယ်.
Not as
စီးပွားရေးလုပ်ငန်းရှင်တယောက်အနေနဲ့နော
်. It's amazing what she writes.
ဒီမှာရေးခဲ့တဲ့အရာတွေကအရန်ကိုအံ့ဩထူးဆန်းစရာဖြစ်ပါ.
Her instruction to the church.How to manage the church
or are a thin or go blue u song lou song am le so that
her instruction how to live a successful life
bo a that da ma le aung myin daw tu ne blue yet di shin tan am le so
that it's amazing
a chan pe jet twi a yan go an aw sia phit par
after that many years of reading I confirm
ni paung mya so a phat la pi de naw ma chano a ni ne ဘလို့အတည်ပြုနိုင်တယ်လဲဆိုတော
့ The word is really from God not from herself
သူမရေးတဲ့အရာကဖခင်ထံမှလာသောအရာဖြစ်တယ်သူဟာသူလျှောက်ရေးတာမဟုတ်ဘူ
း In 40 years that I read I have not found a single place where I doubt her writing
ဒီပေါင်း40လောက်ဦးလေ့လာတဲ့အချိန်မှာသူမရဲ့အရေးသားကိုကျွန်တော်တန်တရားဖြစ်စရာကောင်းတဲ့နေရာတစ်ခုမှမရှိပါဘူ
း People say she copied from other people's writing
လူများဘယ်လိုဆွဆွဲလဲဆိုတော့ Ellen White ကလူများရဲ့စာတွေကိုလဲ copy ပေါ့နော်ကူးချခိုးယူကူးချတယ်လို့ဆွဆွဲတာ
You have heard that
တချို့လဲကြား
Do you believe so?
အဲ့လိုယုံလား
Cannot be. Yes, she has copied.
မှန်ပါတယ်သူမိညာတဲ့စာအုပ်တွေရှိပါတယ
် But is that a problem?
ဒါပြဿနာလားဟု
တ် It's not a problem.
တမိုင်းကို
When she catch a vision Especially in great controversy, you read, and then the middle part hardest to read.
The great controversy, you pa ji man ma ya su ne pat tat lu tu ma shin pya de ya ni a chang phin pyet ni.
And then after you cross this middle part about the history of Europe.
The Europe dai no among ke kala ne pat tat de ya su win ko tu ma ye bi de naw pai.
Then you read the last part exciting again.
Naw pai sat phat lai mae su yin le da sait lu sha sia.
But if you were to read her first, second, third translate third
chapters?
No, first edition.
သူရဲ့ပထမထုတ်ဝေတဲ့စာအုပ်ကိုဖတ်ကြည့်မယ်ဆိုရင်
Second edition, third edition.
ဟာဒုတိယဒီဖြတ်တဲ့အခါတတိယဒီဖြတ်ထုတ်ဝေတဲ့စာအုပ်ကိုဖတ်မယ်ဆိုရင
် It's exciting to read right through.
တကယ်စိတ်လှုပ်ရှားပြီးတော့
Mrs. White's writing has power.
သူမရဲ့အရေးသားတွေကတကူပါ
language a way that is so powerful
သူရဲ့ဘာသာစကားအသုံးနှုန်းရေးသားမှုအကုန်ကတကူပါ
the 1911 version of great controversy middle part is the hardest to read.
Controversy.
The middle part is the hardest to read.
啊，列班亚罗，帕拉，克苏梅。
I believe she copied from historian.
都你读嘛？你呢？你读嘛？伊些啊，对耶，啊，抄查查列对个，都故意打的，巴里梅。
What she saw, she wrote in. She wrote down.
유바요마미야야리고두.
Then later on, she went to Europe.
에리체마두두마유럽을래야오.
She discovered historian. She looked at facts.
에리야우요바야다마이네요래두고라인뚜이게야래.
It confirms her vision, what she saw.
두뚜이게래야리야두마유바요마뚜이야야리네다탓해.
So she used passages, probably from historian, to prove what she saw is true. And she has acknowledged this in her books. There's nothing wrong with that. If you were Mrs. White, you will also do the same. What you saw, what historian has written, you will definitely try to quote.
To prove
your vision is from God is
correct.
So copying and acknowledging that she has copied is not an issue. But some people who wants to oppose her and say this is no good. She is supposed to be a prophet. To me, I think this is majoring in a minor. To distract us from reading God's word. To distract us from having the testimony of Jesus. Agreed? So please read your Bible and please read Mrs. White's writing. It is important. Number 10. They are perfectly zealous in their work.
Verse 13. Yes.
Here, a voice from heaven say to John, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from now onwards, henceforth. Yes, say the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their work do follow them. We are saved by grace. But here we are judged by our works. They may rest from their labor. That means what they do will follow them. The work will show the world what how faithful are they to obey God's word. How zealous are they in keeping God's word. Their works will follow them. So when we do something, no matter how small it is, no matter how important it is, do it well. For God honors each one of us that do our work well.
ကျွန်တော်တို့အကောင်းဆုံးလုပ်တဲ့အရာကိုဘုရားအသိမှတ်ပြုပါတယ
် He don't want lukewarmness
မဘူးမနှွေးလုပ်တဲ့အလုပ်မျိုးဘုရားမကြိုက်ပါဘူ
း He rather that you call and leave the church
အေးပြီးတော့အသင်းတော်ကနေထွက်ရင်ထွက်သွားပ
ါ than to be lukewarm and do nothing
မဘူးမနှွေးပဲနဲ့ဘာမှမလုပ်ပဲနေတာမျိုးတော့ဘုရားမကြိုက်ပါဘူ
း And when people are hot the lukewarm will say don't be so hot
တခါတည်းကခင်ဗျားတို့ကပူပူနဲ့တောက်တောက်ပြောင်ပြောင်လှုပ်တဲ့အခါမှာလည်းတချို့ကမင်းတို့အဲ့လိုမလှုပ်ပါနဲ့လို့ဒီမပူမအေးသမားတွေကပြောနေ
တယ် Their work will follow them
သူတို့အကျင့်ကသူတို့နောက်သူလိုက်တယ
် Revelation chapter 18 verse 1 and 2
ဗျာဒိတ်ကျမ်း18ငယ်1နဲ့2မှာ
This group of people are filled with the latter rain
ဒီပုဂ္ဂိုလ်တွေကနောက်မိုးနဲ့ပြည့်ဝသော
And they will light up the world
ကဘာကြီးကိုအလင်းနဲ့ကြီးသောအလင်းဖြစ်စေမဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ဖြစ်ပါတယ်။အငယ်တက်မှာဖတ်မယ်ဆိုရင်ထို့နောက်မှာကောင်းကင်တမန်တစ်ပါးသည်ကြီးစွာသောတကုံးနှင့်ပြည့်စုံ၍ကောင်းကင်ကဆင်းသက်သည်ကိုငါမြင်၏။သူ၏ရောင်ခြည်အားဖြင့်မြေကြီးထွန်းလင်းလျက်ရှိ၏။ထွန်းတောက်လျက်ရှိ။ထွန်းလင်းလျက်ရှိ
။ We are coming in chapter 18. We are jumping ahead.
အခန်းကြီး18ကိုကျွန်တော်တို့ကြည့်မယ်ဆိုရင
် In verse 2 and 3 it is the final battle.
Yes, 2 and 3 ma so now so tight lan mwe a chang.
When the message will finish, where God's people will finish the spreading of the gospel.
Phaya ya da thami rue evangeli thadin saka, no. Thawara evangeli thadin saka ko a song tat, no. A shei a hon ne.
John said after these things.
Da ri a long ye a pi ma.
I saw another angel.
ကောင်းငင်တမန်တပါးကိုထပ်တွေ့တယ
် from coming down from heaven
ကောင်းငင်ကကောင်းငင်ကဆင်းလာတဲ့ကောင်းငင်ပါဖြစ်တယ်
angel have great power
ကြီးစွာသောတကူရှိတယ
် and the earth was lightened with his glory what does this mean
တကဘာလုံးကသူ့ရဲ့အလင်းနဲ့ထွန်းလင်းလျက်ရှိတယ်ဘာအဓိပ္ပာယ်ဆောင်းလဲ
so I searched Mrs. White's writing
Mrs. White ရဲ့အရေးသားတွေကိုကျွန်တော်ရှာတဲ့အခါမှာ
she's referring this to the lettering
The
power, angel with the power is the latter rain.
The good guy, the kind of man, ah, when you know that be what it, yeah, then no.
And because of that, the whole earth is lighted.
Eddie, a move, change, ah, John, the kabalong, ah, yeah, a bone on it, turning out, yeah.
The loud cry after the latter rain, it will be a loud cry.
နောက်မိုးရရှိတဲ့အခါမှာကြီးစွာသောအသံနဲ့ကြွေးကြော်မဲ
့ in bonus
မှုဖြစ်လာလိမ့်မယ
် God's final group of people will finish the work
နောက်ဆုံးသောဘုရားရဲ့သားသမီးတွေအရှိန်အဟုန်နဲ့ကျယ်သောအသံနဲ့အမှုတော်ကိုပြည့်စုံစေမှာဖြစ်ပါတယ
် whether with money without money doesn't matter
ပတ်စံရှိသည်ဖြစ်စေပတ်စံမရှိသည်ဖြစ်စေအရေးမကြီးဘူးလေ
it is not money that helps to finish the workThat finishes the work. It is helpful, but it is not the tool.
ငွေရတော့အမှုတော်အတွက်အထောက်အကူတော့ပြုပါတယ်ဒါပေမဲ့ငွေအားဖြင့်တော့မဟုတ်ဘူ
း If our faith in God is totally trusting God
ကျွန်တော်ရဲ့ယုံကြည်ခြင်းကယာနုံးပြည့်ဘုရားပေါ်မှာခိုးလုံကိုးစားပြီးလှုပ်ဆောင်မယ်ဆိုရင
် God can do wonders
ကြီးစွာသောအမှုနော်နမိတ်အံ့ဩဖွယ်ရာကောင်းတဲ့အမှုဘုရားရှင်ပြုနိုင်ပါလေ
Like Gideon with 300 soldier 300 men
Gideon နဲ့သူ့ရဲ့ရဲဘော်300
Only lighted the torch and blow the trumpet
တပိုးတလုံးနဲ့မိတို့တယောက်တစ်ခုစီတဲ့
Around the enemy camp
ရန်သူရဲ့တပ်စခန်းကိုဝိုင်းရံပြီးတော့
That's all they did
သူတို့ဒါပဲလုပ်တယ
် And the whole camp 120,000 soldiers died fighting each other
Yanu 3000 a chin chin tai khai pi lo
So 15,000 is left for Gideon's 300 men to fight
1000 kwe la kwe jan pi lo Gideon ne lu di tai pi lo thuru ko shin lin mlai
That's the power of God
Da phaya shin ye tagu ro phit par
Verse 2 it says and he cried mightily with a strong voice
Ngai ne ma che do tan ne jwe jor de lu pho pya
So what is the loud cry the message of the loud cry
ဒီကျေသောအသံနဲ့ကြွေးကြော်တဲ့သတင်းစကားကပါလေ
Babylon the great is fallen
ဘာဘူးလုံးကြီးပြိုလဲပြီပြိုလဲပြီလို့
This is the same as the second message of the three angels message
နောက်ကောင်းကင်တမန်သုံးပါးသတင်းစကားရဲ့ဒုတိယသတင်းစကားနဲ့တစ်ထပ်တည်းဖြစ်ပါလေ
If you turn to the three angels' message, which is found in
Revelation 14, ma, three are going to my two mother in the garden.
Let's turn to that and read together.
Can you suddenly and get chop? Shall we read together?
Read together. This is important. This is the purpose of our existence as Seventh-day Adventist Church.
From verse 6 to?
Verse 6, first angels first.
Patamalu Pamela, Chao Kune, Trijavilan.
Let's read together.
Can you say, in a chop? 1, 2, 3. Nijiboma, Nido, Dudi, Hudo. Adidi, Bada Zagago, Biodo, Lumune, Katinua, Taura, Emily Diago, Hoyado, Gong in the Mandabaga. Piada Kingo, Chao Yun, Chimunjalo. Diasi no Mudo, Che, Yaulavi. Gong in Yeji, the Modiani, Say Drinogo, Pansino Mudo Shingo, Gugwe Jalo, who Chido than a Piosu, Gong in Lenai, Pian Welia Shidigo, Nami.
I guess Myanmar Church don't have the habit of reading the Bible together. Let's try again. It's important to be united.
But now the thing is, pay on, you know, do the qua.
Let's read this again. In united love.
เจเจเนี่ยญีญญาญาลิผัดเอาฉောက်เนี่ยคุณเนี่ยญีจีบ่มานี่ดอดุริหุดออตีตีบาตาสกาโกเปียวดอลูอมโยนวยคัดติ้งโตอาทาวระเอ็งกฤติยาโกฮ้อยาดอก้องเกตะมันตะบากพะยาทะคิงโกจ่าวยืนล้วยฉีมนจาลอเตียสีนอมุดออเฉิงยောက်ลาบีก้องเกเมจีตะมุฏฏยาเนี่ยสั้นเยดรินโตโกพันซินดอมุดออเฉิงโก
Mrs. White says the first angel message was pronounced between 1840 to 1844.
That's where
they understood the first angel's message.
Yeah, but proclaimed.
What does the first angel message says?
It
says an angel was flying in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel. Is there a difference between the gospel and the everlasting gospel? Who thinks there is a difference?
Only one. Two. Two.
Two. Two. Today, people say we have the gospel. Jesus came to save us from our
sin. Is that the
gospel? Is that the everlasting gospel? It is the gospel that is preached by the whole Christian world. But the everlasting gospel that Seventh-day Adventist preaches is different. It explains why Jesus has to come. And what is the result of Jesus coming? It deals with the great controversy that started in heaven, how sin, how Satan became, how Lucifer became Satan. It goes all the way back to the creation. How God created a perfect world. And how man sinned. And how God prepared from even before creation. If man sinned, what will he do?
Son of God came
in the middle of it to save
man.
So that one day we will be in heaven. When Jesus comes, that's the everlasting to everlasting gospel. So, remember this. We are not only to preach the gospel, but the everlasting gospel. It brings meaning for why Jesus has to come. The past, the present, and the future. It says this angel. Angel stands for what? Are you an angel? How many of you are angel? Only few. Pastor, are you an angel? I hope so. When we think of angel, we think holy, holy, without
gall.
Perfect. The three angels are three messengers from God. We are the messengers. We are the angels. To preach to the whole world. The everlasting gospel. And what is the gospel? Everlasting gospel. Verse 7, it says, they say with a loud voice, fear God. Give glory to him. For the hour of his judgment is come. Judgment will be coming soon. In fact, judgment has started when? 1844. In heaven, the book of life is open. And Jesus is judging. So that's why Mrs. White said the first angel message is 1840 to 1844, where it was pronounced Jesus is coming again. But actually, his judgment is coming. The message also calls to worship him. Who? Who is Jesus? He is the creator that made heaven and earth and the sea and the fountain of water. He's not a good man only. He is the creator God. So, as a church, we are pointing the people back to our Creator. During that period, the world started preaching evolution. And God raised up a small group of people to preach about going back to worship the Creator.
Charles Darwin
Let's read the second angel's message.
After
the 1844 disappointment,
the
They were waiting for Jesus to come. Judgment started in heaven. God told Mrs. White, after that, the Protestant church started to backslide. That's why this second message came about. Babylon is fallen, is fallen. That great city, because she made all nations drunk of the wine of the wrath of her
fornication.
Not only the Catholic Church,
Catholic,
but the Protestant Church. Has rejected the first message.
But
so God pronounced Babylon is fallen, is fallen. Then the third message, the angel's message. Let's read together verse 9.
9 and 10.
This is a hard message to preach. But this is the third angel's message, is the message that we are to preach. If you read Mrs. White's writing, she always mentioned the third message, the third angel's message.
Ellen White,
not only we have to preach about the Creator God, the judgment, we
have
to preach the second message that this world and the churches will fall. But the third message is what is important. For today, it says with a loud voice. How loud is our voice as the Seventh-day Adventist Church in Myanmar? It says if any man worship the beast and his image, or receive the mark in his forehead or in his hand. The warning is the same shall drink the wine of the wrath of God. Which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. Is this a good news or bad news? How many of you think it's bad news? So, how many of you think it's good news? Are we preaching this news? Good news. Why is it good news? We may raise the hand in the church, but outside we don't dare to preach. Am I correct?
Yes.
Why is it terrible message if the people don't receive it?
It's a
good news when people accept that, wow, God has already told us this will happen. I don't want to be among them.
So how
you share this bad news to them to become good news for them?
It's
important. It is necessary to share this. Otherwise, no reason that we should exist.
We are
God formed us together to be united to finish His work of preaching the three angels' message, especially the third angel's message.
Then we see in
Revelation 19, celebration. After all this,
verse 1:3.
Hallelujah. Let's all say together, Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Conviction.
Hallelujah.
Indeed, there will come a time where we will celebrate. If we don't do our part, we get to heaven, we cannot shout
hallelujah.
We are not as excited as this last group of people
who has
fought a good fight
and
won on behalf of God, Jesus.
And
when they see the God judge the sinners,
they are
satisfied. When they see heaven,
they are
satisfied.
When they
see Jesus face to face, the one who has led them through,
they are satisfied. Then what
do they do in heaven?
Verse 4. Amen. Hallelujah. Verse 4.
Yes. 24.
Yes.
What will the 144,000 do when they get to heaven? For
the 1,000 years.
John saw thrones were set up.
Johan ba mien le so lo plin nwe go pyin sin tha da go twei de.
And they, the 144,000, set upon them.
The 3,000 lu re ya plin mo ma thai ya me.
And judgment was given to them.
Si ya de akwin go phaya shin thu lo go pe ba le.
In 1844, when Jesus opens the book of life, He judged the people in the book of life. How do you get your name into the book of life? Yesterday I mentioned.
How?
When you accept Jesus as your personal Savior, your name is written there. Before Jesus, if you accept the sacrificial system, the forgiven of sin by the slaughtering of the lamb,
your name is there.
When you accept God, your name is written there. The Creator God. The first name in Book of Life that Jesus judged, what is his name? Adam. Second name.
Dudia.
Eve. Third name.
Adam. Ewa. Nabulam. Dudia.
Cain or Abel first?
Abel.
Cain.
Okay.
Fourth name.
Sruta.
Abel.
Abel.
All these four names, no Jesus, right? No God. So 1844, Jesus opens this book and judge. Starting with Adam.
Adam.
Cain. Cain is the elder son, right?
Cain.
Then Abel. And then Seth. And go so on. And he will start judging one for one. Whether their name should remain or should be crossed out.
So,
is your name crossed out or left there? We don't know. There will come a time that Jesus will judge from the dead to those who are still alive, like us. So when he finished all the judging, he closed the book. Not long after that, he will come. That's why those who are sealed. No more judgment. There is no intercessory. Of the 144,000, they will not sin. Because there's no intercessory. Jesus has left the temple. So this 144,000, or the multitude together, in Revelation 20, it says they will judge the sinners. The billions and billions of people. It could be their relatives. It could be their wives, their husbands, their children, their friends. It's a terrible thing if they are not with you in heaven. But God wants to make sure you understand why they are not there. So one by one, their names will be called. And the saints will judge. I saw the throne and they sat upon them. And judgment was given to them.
And
I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the weakness of Jesus.
And
weakness for the book of God.
And those
that have not worshipped the beast.
Those that
have not worshipped the image of the beast.
Those
who have not received the mark.
They
live and reign with Christ 1,000 years.
In that 1,000 years,
all answers are answered.
Mrs. White goes
even further and say they will decide the fate. What is the punishment for each of the sinners?
D. Ellen White, I've loved you, yes, or D. Ma Eddie, Jesse Jin Yawda, do the yet, Ganjama, will add attention to the
how long will they be burned in the fire?
No, can you let me? I'm a
blue. Satan will be burned the longest, she says.
Sadamanaro, a chashi zoom.
This lake of fire is not meant for us.
It's
meant as a punishment for Satan and his angel.
Let's
warn them. It's a good news to warn them early. Have your friends, your relatives, strangers, people in Myanmar knows
that soon
judgment will start for the sinners.
Now
the judgment is on for the saints, those who are in the books of life. Revelation 22 says, behold, I come quickly. Blessed is he that keepeth the saying of the prophecy of this book, Revelation. Revelation is a book that Seventh-day Adventists needs to share, understand and to
share.
Verse 12 says, behold, I come quickly, and my
reward is with me,
to give to every man according to his work.
Verse
14, it says, blessed are they that do his commandments.
That
they may have the right to the tree of life
and enter
into the gates, into the city, the glorious city, the New Jerusalem.
What a
blessing, what an assurance, what a
promise.
Nothing can compare
what heaven has offered
than what the earth, what Satan has to offer on this earth.
Today,
Jesus says, come.
Come.
Come. For in verse 17, he says, and the Spirit and the Bride says, come. Holy Spirit and Jesus and the church, bride is the church, goes out and gives this message, say come. Holy Spirit and church comes together to finish this work. Come.
The invitation is to come.
And Jesus says, let them who hear says come.
No.
That means the gospel is first shared, and then those who hear will share again. If the Americans did not come, or the British, was it British?
Rude, yeah.
Missionary.
Yes.
Who is the first missionary? Is he American?
Protestant, but Catholics also come.
No, Seventh-day Adventist.
Adventist, American.
American. If American did not come and share this good news with your forefathers. They even built this church for you. Am I correct? They even built the church for us. The Spirit and the Bride says, come. That's what they did. 150 years ago. I saw your plug outside here. So you and me who hears should go out and say, come. Let them who is thirsty come. The world needs the goodness of God. They are thirsty for our
mercy. They want the
water of life. And it was offered to us free.
Let us offer
to others also free. In close of this session, let's again pray and commit our life.
And
say, God, I want to follow you all the way. If it is your will that I should be this last group of people, the 144,000,
please
the Holy Spirit guide me, lead me, help me to become perfect in your sight.
Let's
separate in twos and threes and pray
of commitment.